which of these two wind turbines performs better in professional tests? The vertical axis wind turbine on the left or the horizontal axis wind turbine as the standard design on the right? You often hear that small vertical wind turbines have important advantages and that they are better suited for decentralized power supply. But can this be backed up with facts? Or are they exaggerated advertising slogans from the sellers? If you are interested in facts in form of the professional test results, then I have good news. Independent tests have been carried out in the USA that provide a good comparison of vertical and horizontal wind turbines. If you are thinking about buying a small wind turbine, you should know these results. The position of the rotor axis is a decisive feature in the design of wind turbines. Vertical axis wind turbines have a vertical rotor axis, horizontal axis wind turbines have a horizontal rotor axis. One design has become the standard for large megawatt turbines in wind farms, horizontal wind turbines with three rotor blades. This is the result of decades of research and development as well as practical experience with these large industrial turbines. In contrast, there's a wide variety of different designs for small wind turbines for commercial and private self-supply with electricity. This applies not only to the position of the rotor axis, but also to the number of rotor blades. There are small wind turbines with 2, 3, 4 or even more rotor blades. All large wind turbines in the megawatt range are extensively tested on special test fields. The aim is to certify the turbines on the basis of technical standards. The quality of the turbine technology is thus verified by an independent body. Such a large-scale industrial plant requires certification as proof for banks, insurers, and of course for the buyers and operators of the wind turbine. But the market situation for small wind turbines is different. Most turbines are not tested independently. And this is partly because such tests and certifications are expensive. And when it comes to testing small wind turbines, the USA is a role model for other countries. Even if you are not from the USA, these test results are very helpful. I'm a neutral expert from Germany, and I think there's an exemplary system in the US to support the market entry of small wind turbines with high quality and high safety standards. And this is crucial, high quality and high safety standards. In Germany, as well as in many other countries, there's not a system like that. In the US, there's the Small Wind Certification Council. It's an official certification body that certifies small wind turbines based on specified standards. Testing and certification are voluntary for manufacturers, but there's a good reason for manufacturers of small wind turbines to have their wind turbines officially tested. This is because only high-quality wind turbines with certification can benefit from rich incentives such as tax credits in the United States. And this is very helpful for buyers of small wind turbines. Only wind turbines that pass the tests are of high quality and receive certification. And, well, that's like a quality label that provides orientation for buyers of small wind turbines. And believe me, there are many small wind turbines of poor quality on the market in every country. When I talk about certification for small wind turbines, I'm referring to the technical standard IEC 61400-2. All national small wind power standards, such as in the USA or Japan, are based on this international standard. The wind turbines are extensively tested and inspected. Power, sound level, duration testing, safety, and so on. The photo shows a small wind turbine test field in the USA on a windy plain. The small wind turbines that are or have been certified worldwide are almost exclusively horizontal turbines, so following the standard design. But here next to me you can see a small wind turbine certified in the USA with a vertical rotor axis. This shows us that also small vertical axis wind turbines can pass the extensive tests and inspections required for certification. The technical quality of this vertical rotor has been proven. You can't expect more as an independent reference for a small wind turbine. And we have concrete, independently determined data at hand to compare the performance and electricity yields of a vertical axis wind turbine. Now let's take a look at the data at the test results. The manufacturer of the small wind turbine is HAWT from Taiwan. The model name is DS3000. And this label shows that the wind turbine generates 2460 kilowatt hours per year, and this applies to an average annual wind speed of 5 meters per second. This corresponds to very good wind conditions for a small wind turbine, as can be achieved in windy coastal regions at a height of approximately 10 meters or 30 feet. At a less windy location inland, you would generate significantly less electricity. The sound level is 42.3 dB, and this applies to a distance of 60 meters from the rotor at a wind speed of 5 meters per second. The output of the system is 1.4 kilowatt at a wind speed of 11 meters per second. And as we can see, a striking feature of the rotor design is that there are two rotors. The inner Savonius rotor is responsible for starting the system, so provides the initial movement, and the outer derrier rotor is responsible for energy conversion when the rotor turns faster. What is now very helpful for us is the comparison of this vertical mini wind turbine with a horizontal wind turbine of almost identical size. A wind turbine which is also certified in the USA under the same test conditions. In addition to the DS3000 vertical axis wind turbine, we take a look at the SkyStream horizontal small wind turbine. The SkyStream wind model has been around for about 15 years. It can be assumed that is one of the most frequently sold small wind turbines for private use. The decisive factor for us is that the SkyStream is once again officially certified in the USA. The prices of the two small wind turbines will be at approximately the same level. A comparison of the two wind turbines is useful because the rotor surface is almost identical. The rotor surface corresponds to the area covered by the moving rotor, the rotor swept area. The rotor size is decisive for the yield of a wind turbine, not the power of the generator. To be clear, the reason I mention these two small wind turbines in particular is that they are both officially certified and have an almost identical rotor size. Now let's take a look at the test results. The rated power of the horizontal wind turbine is 50% higher at a wind speed of 11 meters per second. It is 2.1 kilowatts, while the vertical wind turbine delivers an output of 1.4 kilowatts. And now to the annual electricity yield. The horizontal wind turbine produces 39% more electricity per year, around 3,400 kilowatts per year. And finally, the sound level. As you can see, the horizontal wind turbine is also a little better. The most important value, in my opinion, the annual electricity yield in kilowatt hours. After all, the purpose of a wind turbine is to produce electricity. And this is a clear advantage. The horizontal axis wind turbine generates almost 40% more electricity every year. Imagine you are offered two types of photovoltaic systems for your roof. One type of solar modules produces 40% more electricity every year. From an economic point of view, you would choose this type of system if both systems cost roughly the same. You could say now, well, we are only talking about two wind turbine models. Maybe there are vertical axis wind turbines on the market that perform better. There will probably be suppliers who say that. As an independent expert, I've been observing the market for small wind turbines for over 10 years now. And that's why I can say, don't just go by the manufacturer's claims and advertising messages. When buying a small wind turbine, you need to look for independent references. This does not have to be a full certification, as with the two small wind turbines in this video. If you want to find out more about small wind turbines with an output of about 5 kilowatts, including recommended manufacturers, then watch this video here. Thanks for watching and take care.